What's up guys, Sal here. So since Samsung released its first foldable smartphone, the Galaxy Fold last year, it wouldn't have surprised anyone if this year's foldable flagship was named the Galaxy Fold 2. But it seems that's not what it's actually gonna be called. Samsung is changing the naming scheme a little bit and will market it as the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 2. It seems Samsung's foldable smartphone will fall under the Z umbrella now. First, it was the Galaxy Z Flip and now the Galaxy Z Fold 2. There's no arguing that it is a mouthful, and at 19 characters, almost a full sentence all by itself. But it makes sense as Samsung thinks the foldable smartphones are the future, which I totally agree. And they're gonna launch a plethora of foldable devices in the near future, so branching them under one brand makes total sense as it simplifies their product portfolio. Anyway, we have some more details about the Galaxy Z Fold 2. First up, Ben Geskin made this rendered video based on the leaks, which depict what we can expect from this handset. Ice Universe revealed a few days ago that the punch hole cutout on the inside display will be at an off-center position because of the lack of space inside. The rear camera setup will be similar to the Galaxy S20 Plus, which means there won't be a periscope zoom camera on this phone. Finally, the outer display will be bigger, making the handset useful when closed. Also, the original Galaxy Fold was shipped with a 15 watts of charger, but with the Z Fold 2, Samsung will step it up to 25 watt according to the latest 3C certification. All of their recent flagships came equipped with 25 watt charger, so it isn't surprising to see the same with the Z Fold 2 as well. The battery capacity of this handset is 4,365 mAh, so it will take less than an hour for this charger to charge it from 0 to 100. Also, a few days ago, we learned that the Z Fold 2 will not be affordable as previous rumors claimed it to be. Leak prices for Greece were €2,200, and today we have another European leaker confirming that the handset will be indeed priced over €2,000. He also says the handset won't be available to purchase till the end of September or maybe even later due to the production hurdles. Anyway, Samsung will launch the handset alongside the Galaxy Note 20 on August 5 in an online-only unpacked event. So one of the biggest reasons flagship phones are so expensive in 2020 is Qualcomm's Snapdragon 865 chipset, as not only it's bigger in size, but it also needed OEMs to purchase a separate 5G modem. In 2021, however, Qualcomm is expected to ship the Snapdragon 875 with an integrated 5G modem, thereby reducing the cost. But recently, there was a rumor that the Snapdragon 875 is gonna be at least $100 more expensive than the 865. The Snapdragon 865 cost around $150, so the 875 was expected to cost $250. This scared a lot of people because this hike in price will be carried over to us by the smartphone companies. This means the S20 Ultra with 865 costs $1,400, so the S21 Ultra could cost $1,500 or even more. But thankfully, turns out it was a baseless rumor. The chief of Android police confirmed through his sources that the rumor isn't true, as he says, and I quote, "Qualcomm will feel market pressure from the economic downturn as much as anyone. I expect they'll very much take this into account on how the 875 is priced." So this is a relief. There was also a rumor that Samsung will use the Snapdragon 865 instead of the 875 on the Galaxy S21 because of the high prices, which we can be sure isn't true either. Of course, with that being said, for all the latest updates on smartphone tech, please consider subscribing. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.